Hey guys, Jessica here. I'm going to bring to you guys a workout that you can do from home using weights or no weights. So if you've got a lighter weight and a heavier set, go ahead and grab them. If you don't, you've got some stuff in your house I'm sure that you can use. I've got cans to use for the lightweight section. And I found some peanut butter, since my family loves peanut butter. They're a little bit heavier than the can, so I'm going to use that for my heavier weight. And then you're going to need a mat or a towel to use when we get down to the floor for the core. So in the interest of time, and I want to give you guys a full workout, I'm not giving you guys a warm-up, so make sure you guys warm up first. So go ahead, go warm up, grab your equipment, meet me back here. Alright guys, we're going to start with those lighter weights, those can goods, or no weights at all. We're going to do two shoulder raises to the front, and then to the side. So lift it up, and back down. Keeping those hands, those elbows all in line with those shoulders, trying not to go too high with it. Nice and in control, don't throw that weight around. If you don't have the weight, really feel that muscle squeeze. You can also do this one arm at a time. Up. So one arm will look like this. Good job. Couple more right here. To the side. Looking good, guys. One more time to the front. A nice squat. We're going to hold it, so make sure you're low enough, but not too low. Palms face out. We're going to do a circle press. So pressing it up and down. Feel that range of motion with the shoulders. You can also do this one arm at a time. Engaging that lower half at the same time. Or you can shorten that lever if it hurts those shoulders. Good job. Pull that belly button right on into that spine. Make sure all the weight isn't in your toes, but you have a nice, firm balance. Keep going. Looking strong. In two. And one. All right. Stand it right on up. Release those legs nice, soft. Pull it to the front. Now out into a W. Push it up right in front of you. Pull it back down. Now out into a W. Good job. You can do this one arm at a time as well. And then do the other side. Good job. Keep going. Keep breathing. Don't hold that breath. Strong two. And last one. Bring those elbows to a 90-degree angle. Open it up. Bring it back in. Keep those wrists and those elbows nice and wide. Pour it at a 90-degree angle. Open up that chest and squeeze it back together. Keep breathing. Yeah. Good job. Couple more seconds. And last one. Back to the beginning. Two front raises. Now to the side. Remember those options from the first round. You can do one arm at a time. You can even shorten your lever. Good job. Keep going. We're holding each exercise for about 45 seconds, give or take a little bit. Good job. Keep breathing. We're almost there. Stay last time to the side. Alright, let's bring it back into that squat. Palms face out. Maybe sit a little bit deeper this time. So circle, press it up. Shorten those upper if you feel like that lower back starts to arch when you bring it on up. From the side, let's flip this. Good job. Keep going. Breathe through it. Those legs will start to shake. Couple more seconds. And two. And one. Release those legs. Palms face us. Push it away. Now palms still face us into a W. Up in front. Pull it back down. Push. Pull. Push. Those knees are nice and soft. Remember, you can do one arm at a time as well. Good job. Squeezing those shoulder blades in as you come out to the side and pull it back in. Good job. A few more seconds. We got this. There you go. In three. And in two. Those elbows in, try not to let them fly. Last one. Alright, bringing those elbows 90 degrees. Open and close. Good job. That belly button tucked in. We'll make this a little bit harder. You can bring it back down into that squat. Make those legs burn. Two more seconds and three, two, last one, and really shake it out really quick. Shake out those arms. We're going to get into that heavier. You can use one heavier or two heavier. For this one, I'm going to use one heavier piece of whatever you have in your house. You're going to bring your hips to be about hip width apart, your feet hip width apart. Arms are right at a 90 degree angle. We're going to lift it up. And bring it back down. Lift it up. Back down. This is really going to work on that shoulder movement, so really pay attention to what your range of motion is. Even if it means you're stopping right here. The more you do it, you'll find that that range of motion increases, but you don't want it to bring it any higher than right here. Good job. Keep going. In two. And last one. You can use both of your heavier weights or one. Skull crushers. Bringing it up and down. Or overhead tricep extension, whatever you want to call it. Elbow stay right on in to your ears. There you go. Soft, soft knees. And you're not going to pass out on me as we go through this. There you go. Feel that burn. Good job. Woo. Feel those triceps work. Keep going. You got it. Two. Last one. You can bring that weight to your chest, or if you have both, you can put it one on them on each to your shoulder. So you're holding it, bringing it down, bringing it back up. Squat it back. Good job. Push those hips right back to the back wall, whatever you have. Have those knees trapped in one line so you're not coming in and you're not pushing out. Same one area. Hips hinge, then the knees. Good job. I'm gonna make it a little bit harder. We're gonna down three, two, one. Push it up. Three, two, one, press it up. Three, two, one. All right. You only have one, grab your second one. Keep coming out a little bit wider into a sumo position, 45 degree angle. We're gonna bring it back down. And we're going to just curl with those arms. There you go. Really allow those hips to open up. Try not to let your knees fall in. Push them out. Good job. Still standing nice and tall. You're looking strong, guys. Keep going. We're maybe about halfway through. You got this. Get a little bit lower. One more. And release. Using both. Four. One. Lift it up. Bring it back down. Yeah, and lift it up. Back down. Remember that range of motion that you have. Whatever it is for you. Try to keep it nice and just fine. As you lift up, I don't want you to boob to come out. The chest down with nice straight line for that back. Good job. Keep on going. See how much time we have left. In two. And last one. One or both. Both pressure is bringing it back. Bringing it back up. So remember, you're just hinging at the elbows. Try not to swing the upper body. Elbows stay in so we don't fly away. Looking good. Push those elbows in. Really challenge those triceps. There you go. Nice neutral spine. Keep breathing through it. Try not to bring that chin to your chest. Keep the airway nice and open. Check, we got about two more. And last one. Bring either one or both. Front squat. Good job. Three, two, one, push it up. Three, two, one, push it up. Three, two, one. There you go. Find the rhythm that works best for you. Squat a little bit deeper. Good job. Keep breathing. In three. In two. Last one. Alright. Grab your other weight if you don't have it. Nice wide stance, 45 degree angle. Bring it down, sink low. You can also change up the pattern with your arms. We can bring it down nice and slow, bring it up a little bit quicker. Three, two, one, bring it up. Three, two, one, bring it up. There you go. Keep going, keep that belly button into that spine. Nice and secure. Four. Good job. The knees pressed out. I know those legs are getting tired. We're over halfway. We're almost there. Give a few more seconds. In three. Two. Give me one more. All right, guys. Bring it on up. Shake it on out. We're going to bring it down to the mat. Alright. You can completely see me. I want you to either grab your one lighter weight or your heavier one. Either or, use your toes. We're going to do transfers. So put that weight in one hand, bring it back, and switch. There you go. Keep going. Try not to let those hips rock side to side. Looking good, guys. Keep going. A few more seconds. Woo! Those abdominals are being pulled in. You feel them engaged just to hold you up so you don't fall over side to side. the same time you really have those glutes engaged. Good job. Keep it up. Looking pretty awesome, guys. Try not to let those hips sag. Really squeeze the booty, squeeze those hamstrings. Push it up. Good job. Keep going. In 3, 2, and 1. Release, bring it back down. Release that spine, one vertebra at a time. We're now gonna go into V up. So right hand goes to left foot. You're gonna bring it up and back down. Good job. If you need to, you can modify just by bringing and squeezing, stopping and grabbing that knee. Nice little tap. Stay on that one side, don't switch. Not yet. We're almost there. Few more, 3, 2, last one, switch sides, up. Bring it up, challenge yourself as you get through this. The longer you do it, try to push yourself up a little bit higher. Even if it is just by 1 centimeter, you got this. Couple more. Good job. We're getting there.